Google's Android One program, which debuted in India in September, is now expanding to neighboring countries. So joining us now to talk about that expansion is Mark Spoonhour, Editor-in-Chief at Tom's Guide. Mark, thanks for joining us today.
Thank you.
So how does Google's recent announcement to launch their Android One smartphones in Nepal, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, what does this mean for the growth of the company?
Sure. Well, it's all about where the smartphone market is heading, because in the U.S., everyone and their mother has a smartphone, if not two. But in a lot of these developing nations, it might be as low as 10% of ownership for smartphones. So it's about getting smartphones into the hands of more and more people. The three markets that you mentioned equates to 200 million people, in addition to the 1 billion already that Google is targeting with Android One already.
Huge number. But according to some reports, Google's Android One devices have not necessarily seen a great response in India, where this was launched in September. Do you think Android One smartphones will truly be in high demand once it becomes available in some of these neighboring countries?
I think it depends on the experience that you're getting with the phone. Certainly, like, the specs are not very high-end on these handsets. It's a 4.5-inch screen, 4 gigs of internal memory. It's really about you're targeting the audience of people who have never had a computer, never mind a smartphone. This is their primary internet device for the first time for a lot of these folks. So it's not for the high-end market. It's for connecting the people who haven't had something before.
And going off of that thread, what does this mean for the future of Google, especially when it comes to competing with smartphone maker Xiaomi?
Sure. Well, it's about control of the ecosystem, because on Xiaomi devices, and they're now number one in China, and they cracked the top five for the first time worldwide. It's about control over the user experience in the ecosystem. And what that means is Google wants its services front and center, whether it's the Google Play Store or any of its other apps. And on Xiaomi and other devices, they could be sort of shuttled to the background. And that's dangerous, because Google makes most of its money from those services and advertising related to those. So the more they know about you as a user, the more they make. This is not an altruistic exercise. So that's where the competition is really going to come into play.
Great. Mark Spoonhour, thanks for joining us today. Thank you for watching. I'm Morgan Brennan. Have a great day.